Yes, good morning, YouTube. So this is the 40 amp tracer MPPT charge controller that I have running my 12 volt lead acid battery system. So this was the first solar charge controller and my original 12 volt batteries that I set up back in 2013. So this 12 volt DC output feeds various loads in the house. I have some 12 volt DC circuits run. So up above the patio enclosure here, I have a total of four 335 watt panels on my tilting solar panel rack, which I showed you a video of setting that up. Three of those panels feed my 24 volt system, which is over to the right. And then one of those panels feeds the 12 volt system. And what I would really like to do is have all four of those panels feed the 24 volt system. So yeah, I need something to power my 12 volt loads. And one option is something like this. This is a 30 amp buck converter, 24 volts in, 12 volts out. My original plan was to wire this up, and this does have a remote control input where you can turn this on and off. So that's an option. This does work. I haven't tried the 30 amps, but it does put out 12 volts. It takes the 24 volts in. So my 12 volt system has the remote display. And this is really nice having a meter there that can record data. And so at the end of the month, I can read this meter and record the amp hours of DC power I've used in the house and track that. So with something like that, I lose that feature. So my plan was to get one of these DC panel meters here. So the idea is I would take this meter and hook it to the output of this power supply, and I could have a similar feature. I may end up doing something like that with the meter and that separate DC power supply. This one does have the serial RS-232 data connection there that feeds the MT-5 meter. And I think there might be some software available that talks to these older charge controllers. But I've got my newer charge controller, the EP-Ever 40 amp MPPT, and this one has a USB cable, and there's the solar power monitor program that EP Ever makes. And I was thinking one of these is basically a DC to DC step down converter. I could feed my 24 volt in here where the panels are, connect up my batteries right here, connect the DC load here. I could plug this cable in to the data port on the controller, so then I could feed that into the house and have the serial data come in, and I could monitor that charge controller from inside the house and see what's going on. So my thinking is I'm going to take this old charge controller out of service. I'll use it on another project, and I'll put the new EP Ever in place here. So let me throw my transfer switch here. Okay, and there you can see the DC load is now 0 amps. So I'm now feeding my DC loads with AC power. So I've added about 65 watts of AC power on the 24 volt inverter to run that power supply. So now I can just disconnect the 12 volt system. So anyway, let me do a little reconfiguring here, and I'll show you what the new charge controller looks like. Okay, YouTube, I think we got it set up here. I've swapped to the 4215BN. I've got it switched back to the 12 volt gel battery type instead of my lithium ion 16 volts. Pulling in 2 amps off the solar panels, doing about 2.5 amps into the batteries, 3.1 amps into the DC load right there. Now, right now, I'm still connected to the single 335 watt solar panel. And what I'll do tonight, I'll disconnect the solar panel leads after the sun goes down, and then I'll run a pair of wires over from the SBMS120 and connect them up here, and this thing will now see 24 volts for the solar panel input.
Yeah, good morning, YouTube. So I've got my solar panels tilted over to the summer angle now. So you're only looking at them edge on there on my rack, but last night I got the two panels on the right side hooked up in series, and then the two panels on the left side are hooked up in series, and then I've got them wired in parallel down at my combiner box. But let's go take a look at the charge controller display, and also we can look at the 12 volt system as well.
Yeah, so here's the display from the EP Ever charge controller, and this is using the eBox-WiFi transmitter, which is connected to my Wi-Fi network, and then I'm bringing this in with a virtual serial port driver. So my solar panels for this charge controller is actually the DC output from the SBMS120 battery management system. So you can see the battery voltage right now is 27.72, and the charge controller is bringing in 3.18 amps. The batteries are basically sitting at float voltage 13.8 here. There's about 0.87 amps going into the batteries. So I've got about 5.5 amps of DC load, or about 75, 76 watts. And then down here on this bar graph, you can see I've got the current displayed. The green here, this is the battery current. So it pretty much jumps around between a half and 1 amp. The blue is my load. So this was kind of my overnight load. And then I turned on some lights. I think I turned on the kitchen lights here. And then I turned on my home heating system, the solar heat system, which runs some fans off of the 12 volt. So that went up here. And then I'd been running some lights out in the garage and fans up in the attic, things like that. Got up 13, 14 amps. And then it's dropped back down to where it's around 5 or 6 amps right now. So that's the Tracer 4215BN charge controller. And I can view that. And then here is my 24 volt system, and I can monitor that. This is running from a USB cable to a StarTech USB extender. Basically, that's like a 4-port USB hub with a Cat 5 cable that runs into the house. And then I plug the USB extender into my Synology NAS, and then it serves up the USB port over the network, and then I can connect to that from any device in my home network. So right here we're running 38 volts coming in off of the solar panels, 279 watts. You can see here's the same battery voltage, 27.7, so that's the same as we were getting here. This 12 volt charge controller sees the battery voltage of the 24 volt system as its solar input. Okay, and here we have the 24 volt charge controller here, and we're looking at 63, 64 volts on the PV input. So that's like 32 volts per panel, bringing in 745 watts, and we're pretty much hitting the peak battery voltage. It'll start throttling back at 28 volts, and we're getting 21 amps of charging. I typically was only seeing like a little over 11 amps is the most I remember. So yeah, we're definitely getting a lot more charging. And then we're running the home heating system, the solar heat, as well as the freezer out in the garage. So we're putting out about 290 watts of AC power. So let's just go in, do day and browse. Yeah, and here you can see the PV power goes up. Right about here is when the sun comes around the trees that are off to my east, and then it jumps up. We're up pretty close to 800 watts. So I'm not sure today if I'll get over 1,000, because like I say, the batteries are getting pretty full. But if we look at the solar panel voltage, yeah, we were up pretty close to 80 volts there. And now it's pulling it down as we're trying to get the maximum power point.
So yeah, here's my 12 volt system. It's pulling 9.2 amps out of the 24 volt batteries. They're at 27.2, pulling in roughly 250 watts from the 24 volt side. And we're putting out about 236 watts of DC power. So that's running a bunch of lights in the house and also the home heating blowers. I'll be making additional videos. I'll put those over here on the left side. And yeah, if you have any other questions about the system, anything I didn't cover, ideas for future videos, go ahead and post up in the comment section down below. And as always, thanks for watching.